here to teach you how to play Zorba the Greek. So, grab your uke. Make sure it's in tune, and if you need help tuning your uke, then be sure to download my free app, the ukulele app, right now. And when it is in tune, your uke should sound like this. Once you've done that, head to my Patreon page and download a free PDF song sheet. The link is in the description. So first off, I'm going to teach you how to play the rhythm section. The good news is there are just three chords in that all the way through, G, A minor, and D. If you already know them, then skip ahead now. To play the chord of G, put your first finger on the second fret of the third string, your second finger on the second fret of the first string, and your third finger on the third fret of the second string. And the chord of G should sound like this. To play the chord of A minor, put your first finger on the second fret of the fourth string. And the chord of A minor should sound like this. And to play the chord of D, put your first, second, and third fingers on the second fret of the fourth, third, and second strings. And the chord of D should sound like this. Now, all the way through the song, the picking pattern is exactly the same. Firstly, you pluck the fourth string with your thumb. Then you play a downstroke. Then you pluck the third string with your thumb. And then you play another downstroke. So let's try that a few times on the G, nice and slow until we get the hang of it. And basically, if you're playing the rhythm part, then that's the pattern for the entire song. So if you're playing the rhythm section, then the first part of the song will go like this. G six times, then A minor, G, D, G, G. So let's go ahead and play the first section through all together at 90 BPM. 1, 2, 3, 4. Too difficult, was it? So let's go straight ahead and learn the second part. For the second half of the song, you play G four times, then G twice and D twice, then D twice and G twice, then D twice and G twice again, and then G four times. So let's go ahead and play that all together at 90 BPM. 1, 2, 3, 4. If you fancy more of a challenge, then let's go ahead and learn the lead melody. For this bit, you'll need to know how to read tabs, so if you don't, then check out my video here. It'll take you about 2 minutes, and then you can come right back here, and we'll carry on where you left off. Now, the first section of the melody starts off nice and slow, and with the exception of the last note, it's all played on the first string. The first sequence is based all around the notes of 4 and 5, and it goes like this. 4, 5, 4, 5. 7, 5, 4, 5, 4, 5. So let's play that nice and slow. 1, 2, 3, 4, 4, 5, 4, 5, 7, 5, 4, 5, 4, 5. Then you move down a couple of frets and play something very similar based around notes 2 and 3, like this. 2, 3, 2, 3, 2, 0, 2, 2, 0, 3, 2, 0, 2, 0, 3, 2, 0, 3. So let's play that all together, nice and slow. 1, 2, 3, 4, 4, 5, 4, 5, 7, 5, 4, 5, 4, 5, 2, 3, 2, 3, 3, 2, 0, 2, 2, 0, 3, 2, 0, 2, 0, 3, 2, 0, 3. And that last three is played on the second string. That's how to play the first half of the melody, and it's a nice and gentle introduction to get you into the song. The second half is a bit more wild, but it's actually a little bit easier than it looks. To begin with, put your first finger on the 4th fret of the first string. Then put your second finger on the 6th fret of the second string, and just pluck both of those strings together. Then slide both of those fingers up one more fret, so it's on the 5th fret of the first string, and the 7th fret of the second string. And you play through it like this. 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and 1 and 2 and 3 and... And then after the second 3 and, you have a little bit of a riff on the first string. You play the 5th fret on its own on the first string, then you hammer on and pull off on the 7th fret, and then slide down to the 4th fret. So a hammer-on pull-off is when you only play the string once with your right hand, like this. But while the note is still ringing out, you hammer-on with your left hand to get a second note. And then a pull-off is where, instead of playing the string with your right hand, you pull-off with your left hand again to get a third note. And then you slide down to the 4th fret. And hopefully it's still ringing enough that you'll get another note out of that. So the notes are 5, 7, 5, 4. But with a hammer-on pull-off and then a slide down, it should sound like this. And you can see I'm only playing the string once with my right hand, but I'm getting 1, 2, 3, 4 notes out of the whole thing. So let's play through that first part of the second section now. 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and 1 and 2 and 3 and... And then after that you slide down to the 2nd fret of the 1st string and the 4th fret of the 2nd string. And do exactly the same again, but just 2 steps lower, like this. 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and 1 and 2 and 3 and... 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and... Then you slide back up 2 frets and play this again. 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and 1 and 2 and 3 and... And then you go back down again and play this again. 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and 1 and 2 and 3 and... Then you go back up and play this. 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and... Then you play 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and... And then to finish off you play 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and 1 and 2 and 3 and 4. And then on the final 4 you play a G chord. But instead of playing it down here, you play it by barring the 7th fret with your 1st finger, and then adding your 4th finger to the 10th fret of the 1st string. So let's go ahead and play through the whole piece at 90 beats per minute. 1, 2, 3, 4. too bad, was it? But don't worry, if you need to practice, just go ahead and play that part again and again until you're comfortable with each part. But for those of you who stuck around this far, let's have a bit of fun. I'm going to increase the tempo on my Drum Beats Plus app to 120 beats per minute. So if you're ready for the challenge, let's go. 1, 2, 3, 4. To keep up with that one? Well, don't worry if you didn't, because it is a challenge. But for the super duper hardcores who said, no, that was easy, bring it on, let's make it even harder, I'm gonna play through the song one final time. This time, I'm increasing the tempo to 150 beats per minute. This is not for the faint of heart, so I'm giving you fair warning. But if you're ready, then let's go for it. 1, 2, 3, 4. I don't think it was that bad, but it will take a lot of practice until you can manage it. If you can't keep up, then don't feel bad about going back to 90 beats per minute and practicing and practicing and practicing until you can play it there. But put it all together, and that's how to play Zorba the Greek. I've been the ukulele teacher. If you have any requests for future lessons, then let me know in the comments below. I'll be back again soon with some more great lessons and videos for you. Until next time, I love you all, and I wish you the best.